Special Ops Squad, night before the counteroffensive, part 2. Wait, we're still on the night before? Does that mean we're not going out with the Survey Corps?
旧調査兵団本部。まだ志だけは高かった結成当初の話だ。しかし、このでかいお飾りがお前を囲っておくには最適な物件になるとはな。
Is anybody just staring at him? What the hell? This guy's creepy.
巨人だかなんだか知らんが、お前のような小便臭いガキにリヴァイ兵長が付き。
This is all just hazing. Wait, what just happened? Oh, I bit his tongue.
最初が肝心だ。
Yeah, that's a great first impression.
昔はそんな喋り方じゃなかったよね。もし、それが仮にもしリヴァイ兵長の真似してるつもりなら、本当にやめてくれない。いや、全く共通点とかは感じられないけど。
俺を束縛するつもりか、ペトラ。俺の女房を気取るにはまだ必要な。
What is wrong with this guy? He must be a good fighter if they put up with this.
全くみっともない。
ペトラ・ラル。
Petra, we've seen her before.
巨人討伐数10体、討伐補佐数48体。
Assists. I like how it's basketball.
オルオボザド、討伐39体。
Oh boy, here we go.
討伐補佐9体。
Yeah, that makes sense.
グンタ・シュルツ、討伐7体。討伐補佐40体。
It's kind of interesting to think about it in that light, because I guess the insinuation is like how much of a team player they are. Like, oh god, I already forgot his name. Ulua. Ulua? He's got a lot more kills than assists. He's like the only one. And he's full of himself. It's sort of jarring to see his character after seeing like Levi and Erwin, who are so awesome. To his credit though, and also to Levi's credit in the last episode, I feel like with a tight-knit group like this, hazing is sort of inevitable. Like, I don't want to say that hazing is a good thing, but I think that there is something negative when you can join a group too easily. If you feel like you've earned your place somewhere, I feel like you're more likely to appreciate it. And with something like this, where their lives are basically on the line at any given moment, it's really important that they have that unity. In this show, we've seen how quickly things can fall apart when people are thinking about only themselves. And that is not something this group can afford. So they're gonna put Eren through hell. But the flip side of that is they're gonna be really, really great to him when he actually has paid his dues and actually helped them out. But I feel like Eren is well suited for that, just because he's got drive. You know, he's got drive just like them. He has a common purpose with them, and this is the best of the best, and there's, you know, there's nowhere better he could be, so he'll do it. You know, he'll earn it. This is partly coming from personal experience. Some of you guys know that for a little while I worked as a stockbroker. When I first started working there, I started as part of like a mass hire, and all of us got put through a form of hazing. And pretty quickly, almost everybody dropped. But the people who remained became part of the family, and not in a superficial way. Like, we really were family. Like, we lived together, and we ate together, and we did everything together. And because that was the system, it was really important that they select for people who are going to be group-oriented, and not quit, and be really driven. And there were some negative aspects of that, don't get me wrong. But I think the result was I was more connected to that group of people than I've ever been to any other group of workers or coworkers or whatever. For me, it was more than work. It became my life. You could argue that also is unhealthy, but there's a real benefit to that as well. It's something I valued at that time.
みんなリヴァイ兵長に指名された調査兵団切手の精鋭。そして俺が暴走した時はこの人たちに殺されることになる。
Yeah, they're probably way more afraid of Levi than they are of Eren.
久しく使われてなかったからな。中も埃だらけだろう。
それは This is awesome that they just have this castle to hang out in. Oh yeah, he's a neat freak. Speaking of hazing, this is taking me back.
俺はこの施設のどこで寝るべきでしょうか。
お前の部屋は地下室だ。守るべきルールだ。
We got a problem with that?
エレンと呼ばせてもらうよ。リヴァイ兵長に習ってね。ここでは兵長がルールだから。
I can see that.
世間の言うような完全無欠の英雄には見えないでしょ。現物のリヴァイ兵長は思いのほか小柄だし、神経質で粗暴で近寄りがたい。
But she's saying this so lovingly.
俺が意外だと思ったのは、上の取り決めに対する従順な姿勢です。誰の指図も意に介さない人だと。
リヴァイ兵長は調査兵団に入る前、都の地下街で有名なゴロツキだったって。
Someone helped him out. Was it Erwin?
エルヴィン団長の元に下る形で。
Yeah, that makes sense to me, just instinctively.
おい、エレン。
はい。
全然なってない。全てやり直せ。
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense to me, because someone like Levi who's that talented, and also that intense, they're not going to do well with authority. The only way that they're going to get there is through ultimate respect for someone. Just searching my brain for who could fit that criteria, Erwin popped right to mind, just because, like I said, I have this feeling constantly that there's a lot to him. You know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of Fullmetal Alchemist and Briggs. Like, the soldiers in Briggs, they're not so much loyal to the military as they are to Armstrong. And I get the same feeling with this crew, or at least with Levi and Erwin. They have their own little thing going, and so far it seems to be working. Like, they have enough autonomy from the, you know, the military proper that they're all right with where they are. And in some sense, they have a lot of freedom, right? Because they can leave. They can go wherever they want, so they can sort of escape from it. I wonder if they don't have bigger plans. I could see that being a thing. Like, I'm sure they have opinions about the whole military system and the political system. I can imagine so many, like, backroom conversations between those two, especially. 30 days. I want to go now. Oh, this guy talks. I thought he just smelled. He just smelled that plan right out. Yeah, they do have something going on. What's the hidden agenda? Sounds like respect.
巨人になるってのはどういうことなんだ？
とにかく無我夢中で。でもきっかけになるのは自傷行為です。こうやって手を。
Don't. You don't have to show now.
そういえば俺は。
Yeah, that's what I said. How do you know that? A series of flashbacks.
私は今街で捉えた2体の巨人の生態調査を担当しているんだけど、明日の実験にはエレンにも協力してもらいたい。
俺が何を？
それはもう最高にたぎるやつをだよ。
Lots of characters in this squad.
あの巨人の実験とは。
おいやめろ。聞くな。
ああ、やっぱり聞きたそうな顔してると思った。
You just opened the door. Everyone leaves.
それじゃあ聞かせてあげないとね。今回捕まえたあの子たちについて。
This Survey Corps thing just opened up a whole new world. For me, you know, being somewhat in Eren's shoes as the protagonist, it feels like we've graduated. I'm getting, like, that Harry Potter feeling, you know? Like, he's the boy who lived, so he's special. So he's now gonna be involved in everything cool. The guy went from being a nobody to having a packed schedule with, like, the coolest people on Earth. Not Ulloa, but the other people.
まずは過去5回の捕獲時に行った実験の反復から始めた。こんにちは。
Oh my god. Stop.
いい天気だね。お腹すいた？
That was close.
あるところに人間を食う一族がいた。尻の肉はステーキに。もも肉は角切りにしてシチューに入れた。料理という概念があったんだ。そこがお前たちとの違いだね。
She's having a great time in well.
その一族を率いた男の名前をお前たちに授けようと思う。お前がソニー。
ソニー。
お前がビーンだ。
ビーン。Interesting name.
よろしくね、ソニー。ビーンもよろしく。みんなで仲良くやろう。
How is she still alive? Now I understand why everyone left the table when this story started.
夜が深まると巨人の活動が落ちることから、日光により何かしらの活動力を得ていることを裏付ける実験だ。
Well, they're solar powered? That's weird. They're like plants.
ビーンは3時間元気なままだった。
Bean's a big boy.
そして次の段階からは巨人の体と接触する数学の確認へと移行した。
分隊長、あなたが
Yeah, she's the one really hurting.
頑張れ。
How does she have any like authority or influence over what's happening? At least she's passionate, I guess.
何？お父さんも？
I'm starting to feel like she wants to die. This is not healthy. Again, that should have been obvious. I'm trying to understand Hanji and her motivation for this, but it's just bizarre. Like, why does it feel like she'd feel less remorse about killing humans than Titans? Poor Eren, he's just like trapped at this table. I mean, he did it to himself. It's his own fault. The most interesting thing for me that comes out of this is the solar powered thing. But I feel like that maybe gives credit to the idea that they're manufactured and maybe they're grown. Because that seems like a plant function. Or, you know, it could even be like advanced organic technology invention to have solar energy be their fuel source. Eren's kind of lost. I feel like it's extra hard for him to hear this because he just hates Titan so much. Right, that's the question.
Hanji-san だって その脅威を数多く体験してるはずなの
に。 Yeah. My best and only guess is that it's some kind of defense mechanism from fear. Like, if you get afraid to a breaking point, I could see how the other side of that coin could be fascination, maybe.
切断した3メートル級の生首を蹴っ飛ばした時だった。軽かったんだ。異常に。私は思うんだ。私たちに見えているものと実在するものの本質は全然違うんじゃないかってね。
Weird.
私は既存の見方と違う視点から巨人を見てみたいんだ。
That is really weird because I have felt like there's something surreal about them. Well, I mean, obviously, right? But there's something very dreamlike about the whole thing. And there's something metaphysical going on, right? Because Eren's having these dreams that affect reality. His father was able to hand him the key even though his father's not around. There's something else going on beneath what we're seeing.
調査兵団に入ってから驚かされてばかりだ。
That's for sure.
変わり者だらけ。
This whole world is odd.
変革を求める人間の集団、それこそが調査兵団なんだ。よかったら実験の話をもっと聞かせていただけませんか。
I feel like that's a mature response. You may as well like learn what you can.
明日の実験のためにも詳しく知っておいた方がいいかと思いますし。
They're gonna love him, this crew, because he's so willing.
まずは最初に巨人を捕獲した時に私はこう仮定してみた。
I actually really like that response from Eren. I feel like that's really mature. Instead of getting bored and looking forward to going to sleep in the basement, he's actually seeing it as an opportunity. He's like connecting himself, his own passion, to Hanji's passion, even though they're really different people. Hello. Also, just as someone who likes to talk a lot, if I'm Hanji right now, Eren just won me over. Like, I'm in love with him now. Because he's giving me the opportunity to express and share my passions, which obviously not many people around here will do. And the sun rose. Oh, that's useful. Thank you.
今まで話したことは訓練兵の時に教わってるはずだ。エレンも知ってるよね。
はい。
Oops。
ここからは私独自の推測を交えてもう一度解読するよ。
Hang in there, Eren。
ハンジ分隊長はいますか？被験隊が巨人が2体とも殺されました。
Oh no, she's gonna freak out. She doesn't look tired at all, though. Talking about Titans just gave her energy.
見ろよ。ハンジ分隊長は
殺した。Gone nuts, right.
君には何が見える？敵は何だと思う？すまない。変なことを聞いたな。
See, he has his own suspicions about what they are, and they're not what they seem. This raises some really weird questions about what the Titans are. Is any of this real? Like, is the world even real? Something's controlling them, or growing them, or something, right? I mean, I think there's evidence for this even going back to the beginning when the Colossal Titan appeared. It just appeared in a flash. That's not an accident, right? There's like a will there somewhere. It's not like there are just beasts roaming the planet. And there's something about their physical structure that doesn't match their...appearance. But they're not illusions, like they can interact with the physical world, they can obviously eat people, but they're super light, they're hot inside, and they're powered by sun. I don't know what that means. All I know is that the answers are in the basement. Not this basement, the other basement. And Erwin has something figured out, or he's a little bit ahead of me, at least. I mean, he's way ahead of me. That was a really fun, but also really bizarre episode. Like, I have some very strange thoughts and feelings about Hanji. My feeling in this show so often, and I can't remember feeling this way in other shows, is just like concern for their mental health. A lot of them just feel really off. Like, they're really off and unhealthy. Like I said, it makes sense just because of the extreme amount of stress they're under. We see how they handle it in such different ways. Eren handles it by doubling down his ferocity. You see people like Wellman who are just...on the constant verge of collapse. Then you have Pixis who sort of enjoys it, and also Hanji who leans into it. Leans into it and finds ways to appreciate it and enjoy it. But I feel like all of it is survival mechanism. On the plus side, it is really exciting having Eren with the Survey Corps. They are an interesting cast of characters, and it comes kind of soon, right? Like, we were being set up with the cadets, but then we had the battle for Trost, all 800 parts. Now it seems like we might not see them for a little while. I'm confident that we'll come back to them, like Jean and, I was gonna say Marco, that makes me sad, and Annie and all those people. And so with that feeling, it's nice to exploreThis other group because they're pretty cool. And there's something nice that comes from the feeling of seniority that they bring. Seniority and expertise. I'm really looking forward to this expedition. It seems like there are going to be a couple episodes before that, but I can see how it would be a good thing to get to know these characters first before going out into battle. Because for me, the action will be so much better if I actually care about them and know their names. And I need like 10 episodes to learn all their names. So yeah, that's the end of episode 15. I'll see you guys next time for episode 16.